Hey everybody, just a quick video to answer a question that came up on Reddit. And since it's a 5x5, I thought it'd be interesting to play with for a second. So the question is, how do you test a 5x5 with a voltmeter? There's not a lot of tests you can do, but there are a couple that do test its functionality. I've thrown this little circuit together here just to play with it. But if we look at what's actually inside a 555, there's a couple of things going on. There's the VCC and ground have a voltage divider, a three-section voltage divider between them. Each of those are equal values. So at the join between the bottom two resistors, you've got one-third of VCC, and the join between the top of the resistors, which is also tapped off to pin 5, you have two-thirds of VCC. So there's the first test you can do, actually. With just VCC and ground connected, see if you get two-thirds of VCC at pin 5. If you do, that means your resistors haven't been blown up. That's a really unlikely fault scenario, but it's something, right? So the other test you can do is set different static DC voltages at pin 2 and pin 6, which are the inputs of those two comparators. And that will compare against the reference voltages, which are one-third and two-third VCC. Those will trigger the RS flip-flop and give you an output or not. Let me show you. So all I've got set up here is I've just got power and ground. I've got pin 3, the output, connected through a resistor to the LED. Okay, I've got a couple of pots here to give, or one connected to pin 2, one connected to pin 6. They're set up as voltage dividers. So as I vary the potentiometers, the voltages on those two pins will change. And these two voltmeters are tracking these. This one's tracking that one. This one's tracking that one. That's all. I don't have the set reset or anything else connected. Or sorry, the reset or the discharge connected. So if pin 6 is above that two-thirds voltage VCC, in this case VCC is 12 volts, just to make it easy. So then the two threshold voltages are 4 and 8. So if pin 6 is above and pin 2 is below, then the output will go high. If you take pin 2, let me just reach around here, take pin 2 higher than its threshold voltage, it will go off. Take pin 2 back low, the LED will go on. Okay, so another test that works when it's working properly. You have both of them high. Take pin 6 down to basically nothing, and take pin 4 and pin 2 down below its threshold. The LED comes on again. Put pin 6 back up again as far as you want, and it's latched until you bring this guy back up above its threshold. Right there, and it goes off again. So there's a couple of things you can do with a voltmeter. That's about it, though. The rest of the normal 555 circuit is just a capacitor charging and discharging. Actually, hang on here. So the other thing you can check is the transistor on discharge output. So I've got this guy set just over 8 volts, so it's going to trigger when I move pin 2 across its threshold, right? But I've got this voltmeter connected to pin 7. So when it triggers, hang on here, you gotta go down, then that shows you the 0.7 volts voltage drop between that transistor or across that transistor's collector emitter junction when it's turned on. Okay, so that's another test that you can do to make sure that that one's working correctly. And I think that's about all the tests that you can do with voltmeters that I can think of that will prove that a 555 is actually working. And just to show that this 555 actually works, I just dropped it back into this little chase light circuit, 5554017, a classic little circuit. But anyway, you see that it's working normally. And all that's happening here is that the trigger voltage is being charged and discharged across this capacitor. It's being charged normally and then discharged when pin 7 goes low. And this resistor is just in the charging circuit of that capacitor. So you can adjust that to change how quickly that capacitor charges or discharges. Anyway, that's a classic circuit. You can look that up anyway. So for the guy on Reddit asking, I hope that helps you a little bit. Thanks. Bye.